नमस्ते, आई एम गौरव पांडे फ्रॉम द फैकल्टी ऑफ फिजियोथेरेपी एंड डायग्नोस्टिक इन द डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ डायग्नोस्टिक एंड कम्युनिटी हेल्थ इन द डिसिप्लिन ऑफ रेडियोलॉजी. टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट द सेशन दैट इज इम्पोर्टेंट फॉर जनरल रेडिएशन second and radiographic technique of whole body for BScRT second instrument. I am from Vidyapeeth. Okay, namaste, Amisha Kushwagutia. In the previous session we had discussed about the forearm, AP and lateral view. In this session, we are going to discuss about the elbow, AP and lateral view. Okay. So, elbow, AP and lateral views technique and the X-ray position. That is the part of the radiographic technique of full body force in the BCRT second term. Okay. So, let me discuss about the elbow, AP view. Elbow AP view is a part of the two view elbow series examining the distal humerus, proximal radius and ulna. Okay, distal humerus, proximal radius and proximal ulna. Okay, the projection demonstrates the elbow joint in its natural anatomical position, allowing the adequate radiographic examination of the articulation of the elbow, including the radio humeral and humero ulnar joint. Okay, radio humeral means articulation features with humerus and a humerus with ulnar joint. Okay, indications. This view is clinically indicated for trauma, chronic discomfort or infection of the elbow joint. Okay, it aids in visualizing fracture and or dislocation of the elbow joint. In addition to osteomyelitis and arthritis cases, it is a preferred projection to assess the medial and lateral epicondyle of the humerus for avulsion type fracture. Okay. Patient position. The patient is seated alongside the table. The fully extended arm. So fully extended arm and forearm in a supinated position. Okay, fully extended arm or forearm in a supinated position. Okay. Are kept in contact with the table by lowering the shoulder. Okay, joined to the level of the table. They all must be in the same plane as the detector. Okay, the detector is placed below the elbow joint. Technical factor. The exposure factor or technical factor, it is the anterior posterior projection in the epi projection centering point mid elbow, which is approximately to the midpoint between the epicondyles. Okay, between the lateral or medial epicondyles, collimation. So period to the distal third of the humerus. Distal third. So period to the distal third of the humerus. Okay. Distal third of the humerus. Or inferior to the include one third of the proximal radius and ulna. Okay. Okay. Lateral to the include. Okay. Lateral to the include the skin margin. Okay, medial to the include median skin margin. Orientation. The orientation should be in portrait. Detector size 8 by 10 inches or 18 by 24 centimeters. Okay. The exposure factor that is used in the elbow is 44 to 50 or 2 to 6 mA, 44 to 50 kbps. Okay. SID source to any receptor distance should be used in 100 centimeters. Okay, grid. No, there is no grid used because of less factors used. Image technical evaluation, the elbow is in an AP position with slight internal rotation. Okay, AP position with slight internal rotation. Okay, with slight internal rotation. Internal rotation. Patient's arm should be rotated externally. Patient's arm should be rotated externally to ensure that the trochee and capitulum are seen in the profile. Okay, in the positioning or in the projection. Up next is the practical points. At times, patient may not be able to fully extend their elbow joint. In such cases, partial flexion may be used at the joint. At initial presentation, two AP views may then be required. The first with the forearm flat against the detector, and second with the humerus flat against the detector. Okay. The lateral elbow view is part of the two views elbow series. Examining the distal humerus, proximal radius, and proximal ulna, it is deceptively one of the more technically demanding projection in the radiography. The projection is the orthogonal view of the AP elbow, allowing the examination for examination of ulna, trochlear joint, coronoid process, and the olecranon process. Okay, it is used to assess both the anterior humeral and radiocapitular line. Okay, the indication. This view is clinically indicated for trauma to the chronic discomfort or infection of the elbow joint. Okay, it aids in visualizing fracture or dislocation to any articulating bones of the elbow joint. Okay, in addition to osteomyelitis and arthritis. Okay, the visualization of the posterior pad sign on a trilateral projection indicates an elbow joint effusion and is suggestive of an occult structure if no obvious structure is seen. The tail sign or the triangular appearance of the elevated anterior pad should also raise suspicion of an occult structure. Okay, so the patient positioning. Patient is sitting next to the table. Okay, alongside the table at 90 degree elbow flexion. The medial border of the palm and the forearm are kept in contact with the tabletop. The shoulder, elbow, wrist are kept in same horizontal plane as like elbow AP. Rotate the hand so the thumb is pointing towards the ceiling, ensuring all aspects of the arm from the wrist to the humerus are in the same way. Okay. So the technical factor, it is a lateral projection. So the centering point, lateral epicondyle of the humerus. Collimation, superior to the distal third of the humerus, inferior to include one third of the proximal radiation in the ulna, anterior to include the skin margin, posterior to include the skin margin. Orientation, landscape, the landscape cassette is used. Detector size 8x10 inches or 18x24 centimeters. Exposure factor that is used is 44 to 50 kV and the MES 2 to 6 mm. SID 100 centimeters is used and the grid. No grid is used because of less factor use. Okay. It is also image technical evaluation factor point are same as like algorithm. So it is also performed for any type of injury and proximal radiation ulna or distal humerus or any type of elbow joint injury or any type of fracture dislocation you can see in this after taking this view. Okay, thank you. I think you would like to start with the session. Thank you. Namaste. Namaste, Professor over here. In today's session, we are going to discuss about the forearm, AP lateral view and techniques, and the lateral forearm lateral view and technique. Okay. So, let us discuss about the forum. Okay, and the forum covers two wounds, like radius and ulna. Ulna in the medial side, radius is present in the laterally or lateral side. Okay, so forum AP view is one of two standard positions in the forum series to assess, right, the radius and ulna. Okay. Indications. The view demonstrates the elbow joint in its natural anatomical position, allowing for assessment of suspected dislocations or fracture and localizing foreign bodies within the forum. Okay, these are the indications. Next one is the patient position. Okay, so the view is performed for assessment of the suspected dislocation or fracture and localizing foreign body. Okay, patient position. Patient is seated alongside the table. Okay, second is the forearm is supinated and its dorsal surface is kept in contact with the gasket with extension at the elbow joint. Okay, both elbow joint and wrist joint are also kept in contact with the gasket. Okay, so the position is supinated, forearm is supinated and its dorsal surface is kept in contact with the gasket. Okay, so dorsal surface is contact in the gasket. Okay, this is the AP position. Okay, AP position, AP projection you can say AP, but AP is S like this. Okay, the technical factor or exposure factor, it is the anterior posterior projection, AP projection. The central point mid forearm is it. Okay, collimation distal to the wrist joint. Okay, so distally it covers the wrist joint, proximally it covers the elbow joint, proximal to the elbow joint. Orientation, the gasket orientation should in portrait. Detector size is 8 by 10 inches or 24 by 30 centimeters. Exposure factor that is used is 44 to 50 kVp or MAS in the range of 2 to 6 MAS. SID source to image receptor distance is 100 centimeters. Grid is not used in this projection. Image technical evaluation, trachea and trochlea and capitulum being seen in a profile. Okay, the wrist is in AP position with minimal superimposition of the distal radius and ulna. The arm should be extended appropriately as evidenced by the radial head being seen in the profile. Okay, so next one is the practical point. Contrary to popular belief, the AP forearm view should not be considered when evaluating any occult injuries of the wrist joint and or elbow due to beam tapping. Okay, so forearm, next the session is forearm lateral view. Okay, forearm lateral view is one of the two standard position in the forearm series to assess the radius and ulna. Okay, this is the elbow lateral. Okay, in the same height. Okay, this is the elbow should be flexed in 90 degrees. Indications, this view allows for the assessment of the suspected dislocation of fractures and localizing foreign bodies within the forearm. Okay, next the patient position. Okay, patient is seated alongside the table. Elbow is flexed to 90 degrees and medial aspect of the wrist, forearm and elbow joint are placed in contact with the detector. Okay, shoulder and elbow and wrist should be in the same horizontal plane. This is the view, same horizontal plane. Okay, technical factor or exposure factor, it is a lateral projection. centering point mid forearm region, collimation distal to the wrist joint. Okay, it covers the wrist joint and proximally it covers the elbow joint. Okay, orientation is portrayed. Detector size is 8 by 10 inches. Exposure factor that is used is 44 to 50 kVp and MAS 2 to 6 MA. Okay, next is the SID. Source to image receptor distance 100 cm. Grid, no, the grid is not used because it this projection uses less factor. Okay, so there is no requirement of the absorption of the scattering radiation. Okay, it is only used when large or more factors are used. Image technical evaluation, elbow is in a lateral position as conformation by the trochlea and capitulum being superimposed and the radial head being seen in profile. There should be superimposition of the distal radius and ulna indicating a lateral position. Okay. Next one is the practical point. The lateral forearm should not be considered a view to evaluating any occult injury of the wrist joint and or elbow due to the ventral. So we are not using the we cannot use forearm AP or lateral view to detect any occult injury, any type of injury in the wrist joint and elbow joint. Okay. So I think this is enough. I think you all receive a good knowledge. Okay. After attempting this video or listening this video. Okay. Thank you. Thank you. The session is over. I think this session is very much useful for you or very interesting for you. I think you are satisfied with this session. If you have any queries, then put it into the comment box. I will resolve it later. Thank you. This session is over. This session is powered by Digital Version 2.0. Jayati Vidyapeeth Women's University.